Hello and welcome back to Citizen Pew. This is Citizen Pew Commentary, and today I'm going to be doing a comparison, like a direct comparison, between the Smith & Wesson CSX Micro 9 and the Taurus GX4 Micro 9. So, as you can see, they're both relatively the same size. There are a few differences. I've done a video on both of these. The CSX by Smith & Wesson does have an aluminum frame, which I do like, but the GX4 is a little bit lighter, but I don't know if that's going to matter when it comes to a Micro 9. As far as that, they're both double stack mags, right around the same capacity. The Taurus GX4 is a striker fire, whereas the Smith & Wesson CSX is a hammer fire, and it does have a safety. So, but like I said, I've done videos on both of these, and you can check them out. But for this comparison, I'm going to kind of put them through similar tests. Now, I did bring some Blazer 9mm ammo. I'm going to run the same ammo through both of them just so I can, for my sake, that's how I'm doing my comparison. And I'm going to start off. I got the target set up and I'm sitting about 30 feet away. And yeah, we're going to go from there. And then I'll back up a little bit and get some footage there. I also have the cameras set up, hopefully, so that I can do a slow-mo. I got the one I'm recording on right now set up for a higher frames per second, so that hopefully I can catch it from the side and you can kind of see the recoil that each of these are getting. So, yeah. So, nothing super set up on how to do this comparison. I'm pretty much thinking I'm going to run one mag of this, one mag of this, one mag of this, one mag of this, go back and forth at this distance, see how I do, and then move back a little bit, see how I do, check the footage out, and see if it confirms my opinions. But I like both of these firearms, I really do. But I gotta choose one to be what I'm gonna get proficient with as far as a Micro 9 double stack. Now I do have some Micro 9s single stacks that I'll probably do a video on down the line, but I need to decide which one of these I'm gonna put more effort in as far as getting familiar with. So let me get loaded up and everything, and yeah, we'll start knocking some targets down. All right, now on the Smith & Wesson, there's a 10 round mag and a 12 round mag. On the Taurus, they're both 11 round mags. I loaded everything up with 10 rounds just to make it simple. And yeah, I'm gonna start with the Taurus first. And what I'm gonna do is with the first mag, try to knock all six targets down, and anything left over, I'm going to rapid fire off into the distance and try to use that for some footage on recoil with rapid fire. So, all right, here we go. All right, here we go. Here's the Taurus GX4 first mag. Dang, that's a fragment. Well, as you can see, I didn't get one of the targets, so yeah, I'm gonna set them up and move over to the Smith & Wesson. And one of those ones that missed, it hit something back there, but yeah, I felt a little bit of debris shower on me, so yeah. Remember, that's why you wear your safety glasses at the range. All right, so Smith & Wesson. Here we go. Same situation. Ah, the sights are definitely different. Yeah, that's why I'm trying to figure out which one I like better, because once you get yourself adjusted to these sights, and you move to something else, yeah, you don't shoot as well with something with different sights. So you know what, I got plenty of ammo. I'm gonna set up again, and this time go start with the Smith & Wesson, since I started hitting it at the end, and just see how well I do with it, and then go back to the to the Taurus GX4 and yeah, do it in reverse order. Just try to eliminate some, you know, inconsistencies. All right, I'm set back up. The Smith & Wesson, I do have to aim a little bit higher, I noticed. So here we go. Yep, a little bit higher with this one. All right, let me get this plate set back up and I'll get the Taurus over here. All right, here we go. Got the Taurus GX4. Whoo! Yeah. You know, I like the white dots, the three white dot pattern on the Smith & Wesson better than the Taurus, but with my muscle memory is from my primary firearms, I do better with the Taurus. So I don't know if that's because I'm used to my Glock 17 sight or whatever, or this thing sits a little bit higher. Let me pull the other one out and let's do a comparison. So that's about how high it sits off my hand there. Yeah, I think the Smith & Wesson sits a little bit lower. When you get palm to palm, where my grip would be, yeah. Get those lined up there. The Taurus sights do sit a little bit higher. So, you know what? No, I'm going to load up another mag of each, do one more at this distance, and then I'm going to move back. We'll see how we do. All right, we're going to start with the Taurus here, and I don't know. I think at this distance, this will be the last one. I'm just going to see how fast I can move across the targets and actually knock some down. Well, that was interesting. Hold on a second. So, I just slammed the mag in and the Taurus locked and loaded. Something to note. I don't know. I mean, I don't know if I like that feature. I like controlling the weapon, not the weapon doing things on its own. So I don't know if that's a feature or not. All right, here we go. Not bad, not bad. All right. Let me set the targets back up and we'll do the Smith & Wesson. And while you're watching this, keep in mind, I have not trained with any of these for proficiency and accuracy yet. So this is all still, these are firearms that I am not, I have not started doing what I would call proper or ideal in my situation training on. So I'm just shooting them based on the experience I've had with them so far. So. Well, the Smith & Wesson does not lock its, or push its slide forward if I slam the mag in. All right, here we go. Whew. Yeah. The Smith & Wesson sights, I will have to get used to if I choose this one here. They do, yeah. I don't know if it has to do with the elevation of them as compared to when I have, like I said, I got muscle memory from my primary firearm. So this one is further has a higher deviation from those than the Taurus does, I believe. So, all right. Oh, yep. I'm going to move us back probably about another 10 feet, and we'll see how it does from the distance. All right. All right. So I've moved myself back about another 10 feet, so I'm sitting at about 40 feet away. Yeah. I didn't bring a tape measure. I just measured it by foot. I'm further back, so like I said, this isn't like a high end. I'm just trying to get a feel for which one of these is going to be better for me to go with. But I'm going to start with the Smith & Wesson at this further distance. So first mag, I'm actually just going to take my time and try to knock all the targets down. Here we go. Getting used to those that sights. All right, let me set the targets back up and we'll do the Taurus. All right, here we go, the Taurus. See, that's one thing I don't like, even though I am doing better with the Taurus, I think. All right, here we go. See if I can get some good footage of recoil here. All right. I got one more mag loaded with each of these, so I'm gonna do this test one more time at a further, this further distance. But are you seeing what I'm seeing? All right, here we go with the Smith & Wesson again. And now remember, these are right out of the box. I haven't done anything to them. So they're, yeah. All righty. I'm going to go left to right this time. Well, set them back up. All right, here we go. Taurus. Maybe a good thing, I don't know. I kind of don't like it, but the shoot's great. Alright, that's all I'm doing today for the test between these two guys. The Smith & Wesson CSX and the Taurus GX4. And these are really the two that I was coming down to on looking for a Micro 9 to carry. Before these, I mostly had single stacks. So these are the two double stacks I kind of like the most. And I tell you what, I really liked the metal frame of the Smith & Wesson. Just because I like metal frames, and but for my experience, for the muscle memory I have and probably all the other firearms I'm used to, the Taurus here is doing a lot better with recovery and knocking the plates down, get me on target, than the Smith & Wesson. Now, I'm not going to say that the Smith & Wesson isn't going to be good for somebody, but for me, with the, like I said, what I'm used to sight wise the muscle memory I have and stuff like that, it looks like the Taurus here is the one I'm gonna have to go with. Yeah, which, you know, like I said, I like both of these. That's why they were the two that I'm considering. But you know, I think I had a bias towards the metal frame. I really like it. I think they're both great firearms, to be honest. Whichever one, if you ended up going with one of these two, I think you'd be satisfied with both of them. But as far as me on what I'm going to use to integrate into my personal carry strategy, Taurus GX4 looks like it's going to be the one that I'm going to be quickest to get in line with, and will probably be the least detrimental to affecting my ability with my full-size pistols. Just saying. So, yep, there you go. That's my video. Let me know what your thoughts are. If you have one of these firearms and you like it, leave a comment down in the comment section. You know, like I said, these are out of the box. I haven't put anything else on them, so maybe aftermarket sites would change that. I don't know. But the results speak for themselves. So I'm going to have to go with the GX4 for the Micro 9 as of now that I'm going to start working with. So that's all I have for the video. Don't forget to check out my Instagram page at Citizen Pew. Don't forget I have a member section. It's 99 cents a month where you'll see some videos on ARs and AKs and stuff like that. Magazines that YouTube doesn't want to run ads on. So it is what it is. So you can go and check the member section out for those videos. Other than that, that's all I have. Y'all have a good day.